We see with our hearts and love with our eyes. In a 2020 prison, lusting over a prize. Fighter in disguise, desperate for the will to survive.
What's going on, y'all? It's your boy, MadDad316 here. Coming to you from this slightly more enlightened Mad Den. Here to talk to you about Madden 19 for the culture. How y'all doing today? I hope your day's going well. Mine, it's going pretty good. Can't complain. Hopefully this week, you know, does something well for us. Anyway, Madden Daily Drops was not there this morning. I know some people on Twitter were saying, where's Madden Daily Drops? They told us last week they're only going to be streaming probably on Tuesdays and Thursdays when they drop content from here on out. So we're not going to be able to be getting our silvers every day now, just on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And that kind of coincides with Player Spotlight releases. So tomorrow we will be getting two new future, two new classics, and two new sleepers. And then again on Thursday, and then for the rest of June. So they're only going to be streaming on those 2 days, guys. So we'll be looking for that stream and complaining when it's not there. Anyway, so tomorrow hopefully we will get some new Player Spotlights. Deron Payne will be a great future star. So would Darius Geis. But who knows who they're going to give us. Derwin James would be a great one as well. The classics, Deion Jones, maybe Dak Prescott, Carson Wentz, Amari Cooper. People that, cards people want out there. Not necessarily me, but some people want them. Anyway, the sleepers, who knows who those sleepers are going to be. They're going to put me to sleep. I don't even know who most of those guys even were that came out. Nah, but anyway. Hope this week is good as far as getting us some players that we want for our teams. So what are we going to do with none of this content coming out, guys? We just don't know what to do. I log on every day, don't know what to do myself in the game other than, you know, daily goals and try to sell some stuff and make some tokens, you know, maybe open a few packs, probably more than I should. But a lot of us are in the same boat. What do we do? How do we have fun with this game? So as far as I'm concerned, what I'm going to do is start a new series, and I'm going to call it the Insane Power-Up Posse. And basically what that means is I'm going to get a bunch of power-ups, you know, at every position. Not going to spend more than 3K on them. I'm going to set a cap at 3K other than the fullback, kicker, and punter, because you cannot find a power-up for less. We'll check, but we can't find a power-up for less than that. We'll make exceptions in those three arenas and those three arenas only. But the Insane Power-Up Posse is kind of be like a pack-and-play series. But basically, I'm going to start all of them out at 80. So I'm going to go get these power-ups. None of them I could have had before. So they're all players that I have not played with on this league. And I have to keep myself honest. You guys have seen who I play with and who I use. I'll go over my team currently when I do the selection process. You can see that I'm not using current players that I have right now. So it's all going to be brand new power-ups, cards I haven't used. I'm going to start them all out at 80. And how they can be upgraded is by how I perform in the game. So let's say I score 2 touchdowns. I'm going to be able to mark them up 2 levels for every touchdown. So if they score 4 touchdowns in the game, they're going to go from an 80 overall to an 84 overall team, or whatever it takes to get them all up 4 tiers. So if I win the game, you know, that's going to be another tier. If I complete the game, that's going to be another tier. So basically, did I say 2? I meant 1 tier per touchdown, 1 tier per turnover, 1 tier for completing the game, and 1 tier for winning the game. So the whole team gets these upgrades. That's how it goes. It's not going to be one player at a time. Don't think we're going to have enough time in this series to get that done. So we'll see how this goes. I'm just trying something new out. If you guys have some suggestions for the rules for this series, please let me know. I'm not going to start recording it till later on today, so you guys have some time to get some feedback on that. So let me know what you guys think in these trying times. Also, I appreciate all you guys that stopped by the stream last night. I did stream last night for 3 hours. It was awesome. You know, I only planned on logging on and playing some games and just kind of chat with some people. I didn't have any real goals, as I had already finished Weekend League last night, so I just went in seasons. And where I started off was, I was 2-2. 2 wins, 2 losses. Got in this game, this guy went up 2 touchdowns immediately, and I quit out of there. I was like, I'm not in the mood for this. And as fate would have it, I played the guy, matched me up with him immediately again. And I did beat him again the second time. I got him to do a quick quit. And if you were there, you saw I did get matched up with again a third time. Is that even possible? 3 times in a row, the same guy? And I won the rubber match. I did beat him the second time, got him to quit again. And so I was at that point 4-3. And I went on a tear after that, playing seasons. I was just kind of still playing, not really taking it seriously. But I won the next three games in a row, so I was a total of 5 in a row to end off the season. And then 3 in a row in the playoffs, which made it 8 in a row to get to the Super Bowl. And yes, we won the Super Bowl last night. It was great, guys. It was great for those that stopped by. Chris Smith, Justin, Nelly was there for a little bit. Marco was there for a little bit. Kaput stopped by for a spell. And some new subscribers came by for a little bit. I appreciate all you guys that came through, showed some love, hung out, watched me win that Super Bowl. Opened some packs afterwards, got a little bit of pack love there, so it was a really good time. And again, I appreciate all the support, guys. I'll try to do that more often. So let me know what's up. So as in these trying times, like I said, I'm just trying to come up with some content each day to make it interesting, make my channel interesting. So please, if you're new to this channel, subscribe. If you're already a subscriber, please like the video. Help me get some momentum going for Madden 20. It's trying to keep it energized, keep it so we don't fall off. It's hard. I know every day it's hard to log on and say what we're going to do. I have the same problem as you guys do. Some of you guys aren't playing, but I'm still trying to keep it engaged, keep it fresh for you. So I'm going to try to get this series, the Insane Power Up Posse, going for you guys. So come on. Just let me know what you guys think. If you guys got some suggestions for this. If not, just be watching for the video. We'll kind of let it go as it goes. So again, thank you all for the great feedback. Madden 20 beta, I've given enough feedback on that. I think enough people have given you their takes on that. Pass rush, wind up. Again, the sideline awareness and the catching. I hope that's one thing that's addressed. Mind you, it's a game that's probably, we're not playing the best version of the game that's even done right now. I guarantee you that's kind of the very intro to how good it is. So I'm excited about it. Be pumped about it. Be positive. Don't be scared. Like I said, it felt just like Madden. It felt really good. So I'm excited for the game. I hope you are too. I'm excited for this week. I hope you are too. And this new series. So be watching for it. The Insane Power Up Posse. It shall be coming. Hopefully later today, if not early tomorrow morning. But I will record it later today. So let me know your thoughts, what you guys think this should be, and have yourselves a great day. Mad Dad 316 is out.